Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4-97 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is the weight is suspended from steel and aluminum wires, each having the same initial length of 3 meter and cross-sectional area of 4 square millimeter. If the material can be assumed to be elastic, perfectly plastic, with yield strength, stress of steel is 120 MPa and for aluminum 70 MPa. Determine the force in each wire. If part A is weight is 600 Newton and if weight is changed to 720 Newton. Aluminum modulus of elasticity is 70 GPa and for steel it is 200 GPa. So let's start with the solution. So what we will do is that if you cut this wire over here and draw the free body diagram. So I will draw this free body diagram. Let this is the weight, clear. And this is the hook. Okay. So this is the load taken by aluminium, which is FAL. And this is the load taken by this steel wire, which is F of steel. And this is the weight which is acting downward, W. So what we will do is that we will apply equation of equilibrium that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So F of steel plus F of aluminum minus W is equal to zero. So from here, let this is your equation number one. Now what we will do is that we will assume, and it is also given that assume both wires behave elastically. So what does it mean? That it means that change in length of aluminium will be equal to change in length of steel rod. And we know that this change in length of aluminium is equal to F aluminium into length of aluminium, which is equal to both lengths are same, which is equal to L. So I will write L divided by area into E. E is 70 gigapascal for aluminium. It is 70. Clear? And both areas are also same. So that is A will be same. So I will write it, area of steel is equal to area of aluminum is equal to A. They both are same. Similarly, E, change in length of steel is F of steel into length divided by area of steel into modulus of elasticity, which is 200. So if you solve for force in aluminum wire, so F aluminum will be equal to 0.35. F time steel. Now we will solve it for part one. Let this is your equation number two. So for A, when W is equal to 600 Newton. So put equation two in equation one and value of W. So let me put it, F of steel is equal, F of steel plus F of aluminium is equal to 0.35 time F of steel minus 600 is equal to 0. So from here, you will get F of steel will be equal to 444 Newton. Or you can say this is 444 Newton. Clear? So put F of steel in equation number 2. So what you will get is that F of aluminium is equal to 0.35 times F of steel. So 0.35 multiplied by F of steel is 444 Newton. So you will get force in aluminium wire, which is equal to 156 Newton. Now you have both these forces. So what we will do is that we will find stress in aluminium wire, which is equal to F of aluminum divided by area of aluminum. So F of aluminum is 156 divided by area is given as 4 square millimeter. So area is equal to 4 square millimeter. So in meter, it is equal to 4 into 10 raised to power minus 6 square meter. So I will put the value 4 into 10 raised to power minus 6. So when you solve this, you will get 38.88 megapascal. This is stress in aluminum. You can see the yield stress of aluminum is 70 megapascal, and this stress is less than yield stress of aluminum, which is 70 megapascal. So it means that this is okay. This wire is okay. Now for steel, it will be equal to F of steel divided by area. So F of steel is how much? F of steel is, you can see where is F of steel. F of steel is 444. 444 divided by 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. And when you calculate, it will be 111.11 megapascal. And this is also less than yield strength of steel, which is given as 120 megapascal. So it means that this wire is also okay. Now what we will do is that we will solve for part 2 and for B when W is equal to 720 Newton. So put value of equation 2 and W is equal to 720 in equation 1. Where is equation 1? So this is equation 1. So F of steel will be equal to F of steel plus F of aluminum. So F of aluminum is 0.35 times F of steel minus 720 is equal to 0. So when you calculate it, you will get F of steel will be equal to 533.3 Newton. Now put value of F of steel in equation 2. So you will get F of aluminum will be equal to 186.67 Newton. Clear? So what we will do is that again we will solve average normal stress in aluminum wire, which is equal to F of aluminum divided by A. So F of aluminum is 186.67 divided by area, which is 4 into 10 to the power minus 6. So you will get 46.67 megapascal, which is less than yield strength of aluminum, that is 70 megapascal. So it means that the force in this wire, aluminum wire of 186, is okay. Now for steel, this is equal to F of steel divided by area. So F of steel is 533.33 divided by area, which is 4 into 10 to the power minus 6. And when you calculate, it will be 133.3 megapascal. And you can see this is greater than yield strength of steel, which is 120 megapascal. So what does it mean? That it means that steel wires yields. Clear? So how, what we will do, hence we will find the force in steel wire by using yield strengths of steel. So force in steel wire is equal to yield strength of steel wire into area of steel wire. So this is 120 into 10 raised to the power 6 is yield stress of steel wire into area, 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. So from here you will get force in steel wires will be equal to 480 Newton. There. Now we have this 480 Newton. So put F of steel is equal to 480 Newton in equation number 1. Equation number 1, which is this one. You can see this is the equation. Clear? And W is also 700 Newton. So you will get F of aluminium. So F of aluminium, you will get it will be equal to 240 Newton. Now, what we will do is that we have the yield stress in steel wire will be 120 megapascal. So force in aluminium wire is 240. So stress in aluminium wire will be equal to 240 divided by 4 into 10 is power minus 6, and that will be 60 megapascal, which you can see less than the yield strength of aluminium wire. Clear? So what we will conclude is that we will conclude that based on your first weight of 600 Newton, you will have force in steel wire is 444 and force in aluminium is 156 Newton. While based on 700 Newton load, your force in steel wire is 480 Newton and force in aluminium wire is 240 Newton. And this was all about problem 4-97. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching and your support.